Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we lift up our two hands to heaven and acknowledge Jesus Christ, the head of the church? Acknowledge Christ, the one who has been with us since this conference began. Enormous visitations, revelations, and impartations have taken place. Let's return the glory to Jesus for all that has happened in this conference, all that will yet happen. Let's give him thanks and praise. Lord, we worship you. We celebrate your faithfulness. We magnify you. We thank you for your mighty presence in our midst. We thank you for sitting over this conference yourself, speaking through all our anointed speakers and blessing us so enormously. We celebrate you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name, we have worshipped. My most oppressive time is when people try to introduce me. There is nothing great except by grace. There is nothing great except by grace. It is grace that makes great. There are no great men in my view, but the backing of the great God behind ordinary people that makes them appear great. They are fronting for the great God. There is nothing about you and me that is really an achievement, but an engracement. It is all of grace, all. We are where we are today as a people, great church. We are where we are today as individuals, all by grace. Some may have received that grace in vain. Others have taken full advantage of that grace to find their place in God. But it's all of grace. But grace multiplies by knowledge. Grace is not free. Grace is cultivated. It says, grace and peace be multiplied to you through the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ. My prayer is that the impact of this conference will multiply the grace of God in our own lives. My understanding is this: wherever anyone may be today, it's only a stepping stone to next. This church is taking several steps forward. Every ministry here is going forward. Amen. Everyone that's a partaker with us in this conference, from the first day it began, you are marching forward. Amen. What grace does is to advance destiny. What grace does is to move the carriers forward. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, this conference will never leave you the way it met you. I'm blessed to be here. I vow to make it. I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad to see what the Lord is doing here. It's but the beginning. Destiny is not a destination. It's an adventure. Going from glory to glory, shining brighter and brighter. And that shall be the experience of each one of us as an aftermath of this conference. Father, speak to us yourself. Speak up our destinies. Open new chapters to each one of us by the revelation of your word today. In Jesus' name. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Please, let's get seated. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. I needed to observe protocol. How much time do I have? So I know how much moment I need to stay on any aspect of my little teaching. Let me thank Apostle John Francis for that impactful word. When he told me you are going to be ministering, I said, I must be there where you are on. And then, but he still kept me there somehow for some time. May God forgive Apostle Paul. Huh? Amen. Because I could hear you just roar from where I was, and I was eager to be here. So when he said, can we go? I said, yes, I'm ready. Praise God. That was fire from heaven. There are teachings that enlighten. There are those that enfires. I believe people have been fired up by that light. Shining and burning light. Things that keep burning the soul. I've always loved and appreciated your ministry as one that is speaking from the throne. May that grace continue to abound. How many were blessed in that teaching? Okay. Praise God. Now, I'll be speaking this afternoon on operating the next level mentality. Operating the next level mentality. Nothing defines destiny like mentality. For as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. It is failure mentality that makes a failure. And it is lack mentality that makes a pauper. In the same vein, it is success mentality that makes a star. Our imagination is what sets the pace for our destination. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. And this they began to do, and now nothing can be refrained from them, which they had imagined to do. Genesis 11, verse 6. It is possibility mentality that makes a giant. Because only those who dare ever delivers. Only those who dare ever delivers. Our thought will either make us or break us. And until we change the way we think, we cannot change the way we live. We are told to be renewed, to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. Until our minds are renewed, our lives cannot be transformed. There must be a change in our outlook, a change in our perspective, a change in our imaginations. There must be a change in the way we view things before there can be a change in our lives. For instance, every child of God is redeemed a lion, and that for dominion. So we are redeemed to dominate life's situations and circumstances. But the lion is strongest among the beasts, and it turneth not away for any. Nothing cows a lion. And is the lion of the tribe of Judah, and as Father has sent him, so has he sent us. So we are spiritual lions by redemption. Every child of God is a spiritual lion. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thy enemy. Judah is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, that has gone up. Now, so you hardly find a lion cry, a lion roars. A lion does not shed tears. It carries dominion virtues within it. is just in charge of the woods and the forest. Somebody's crying is over. And it takes a lion heart to have a lion share. It's important. Amen. It takes a lion heart to have a lion share. There is nothing God will ever tell a man to do that will not require the heart of a lion to get it done. There are giants in every man's promised land. It takes a lion heart to take the territory from them. It's important the way we think. Also, we are redeemed as eagles. That means ordained to scale unusual heights. Deuteronomy 32 and verse 9 to 14 talks about the Lord's portion is his people. Israel is the lot of his inheritance. He found him in a dry land, in a dry and howling desert. He led him about as an eagle. As an eagle. So every child of God, Deuteronomy chapter 32, verses 9 to 14, every child of God is redeemed an eagle, ordained to scale unusual heights in life. Ordained to scale unusual heights in life. So you are not a vulture. You are an eagle. You are not a duck to be playing around homes. You are an eagle. That means you are redeemed to be outstanding. It will rule your mind. One of the things that changed my life very early, my spiritual life, my spiritual journey, is the fact that there is no difference between the Jews and the Greek. The white and the black. Now I'll say like my brother John, I would never be a racist. I was raised on the laps of virtually all the ones that were part of my early life were white. The good mother that led me to Christ is still alive. She's in Florida. And I hope to see her this coming week. Now, she's white. I grew on the laps of Egan from 76. He's white. But what I'm saying is this, we have a universal gospel that applies to every race and color at the same rate. Every race and color at the same rate. Because you need a change in your mindset. You need it. For there is no difference between the Jews and the Greek. The same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. There is nothing I've seen in all my journeys that I don't believe can happen where I am. Every time I see anything, and I have these my wonderful mentors, and I see quite a few things around them. Every time I see anything, not competitive spirit. No. With your faith stirred up. It has happened somewhere else. It could happen anywhere else. So, this is vital. Our ministry has never drawn any values financially from any nation of the world till now to his glory as the source of supplies. Because the same Lord, Romans chapter 8 and verse Romans 8:12, the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. There is no difference. So you are not disadvantaged. Perhaps you are ignorant. God is no respecter of colors. God is no respecter of races. He's the father of all. We all belong to one family in Christ. God remains our eternal father. So we share same DNA. Everyone that is born again shares same DNA with God. So we belong to the same order of beings. There should be no place for harassment. There should be no place for harassment. My prayer is that that ceiling which you have placed on your life will be lifted today.
Amen.
Take that ceiling off. It is artificial. It's not genuine. It's not real. Take that ceiling off. It's not put there by God. Ignorance placed it there. Take it off. Take it off. The same Lord over all is which unto all that call upon him. One of my friends, one of the great names in America, ministries in America, he said to me, Brother David, how do you pay for all this? And I said, faith. He said, what do you mean by faith? And I said, faith is a universal currency. Delivers same value in every nation of the earth. Same value. Has the same purchasing power. Faith has the same purchasing power in all nations of the earth. No nation has an advantage over the other. No race has an advantage over the other. That's the way God has made it. In Revelation chapter 5, he has redeemed us out of every kindred, out of every tongue. Verse 9, Revelation 5, 9. Out of every nation, and has made us unto our God as priests and kings, and we shall reign on the earth. Revelation 5, verse 9. We are redeemed from every tongue, redeemed from every kindred, redeemed from every nation, brought into the same one family. No one has an edge over the other. He said, but he's talking about Israel here as a Negro. Yes. Every child of God is a spiritual Jew. Every child of God is a spiritual Jew. For if ye be Christ, then ye are Abraham's seed. And he has according to the promise. Galatians 3:29. Every child of God is a spiritual Jew. So whatever applies to the Jews in scriptures applies to you much more. Romans 2:28-29. For it's not a Jew that is one outwardly, but it's a Jew that's one inwardly. So we are the original Jews. The believers are the original Jews. So you are an original Jew. That's why Christ was crucified, to connect you and me to the blessings of Abraham. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Be made a curse for us, for it's written, cursed is everyone that hangeth upon the tree, that the blessings of Abraham might come to us who are Gentiles, that we might obtain the promise of the Spirit through faith. So you are a spiritual Jew. That should ring a bell. It should fortify your confidence. That you are not just an ordinary citizen of the earth. Every seed of Abraham is ordained a global citizen. For in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. You are not just sitting down as a struggling Nigerian. No. You carry potentials to impart your world. Therefore, open up. You must gain next levels as a result of this conference.
Yeah.
This is vital. It's important. Say with me, I'm redeemed a spiritual ego. I belong to the skies. I'm not a duck playing around homes.
I'm not a vulture
praying on refuse.
I'm an
ego. I take what I want from land or from water.
I'm an
ego. I belong to the top.
Isn't that simple? He said, you are a city set on an hill that cannot be hidden.
That's where you belong. This will change the way you think, because until we change the way we think, we can't change the way we live. Now, we are also told in Revelation 22, verse 12, I mean verse 16, Jesus speaking, he said, I, Jesus, have sent my angel to declare this thing unto the churches. I am the root and the offsprings of David, the bright and morning star. And John 17:18, as my father has sent me, so send I you. So you are redeemed a star to outshine your world. You are redeemed
we must carry this mentality. Most people must have heard me say several times, I'm not surprised that we find ourselves where we are today. I would have been surprised if we are not there. Thank God for being faithful to his word, but thank God much more for being able to see it long before it came to be. From the pages of scripture, because all of God's plan and purpose for us is contained in scriptures. Jesus found his mission from scriptures. The Lord is upon me. It's Isaiah 61. John found it. I'm the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Every of God's plan for his people is contained in that book. It's important to open it and find out what is written of you. Jesus took the book and opened it, and there he found what was written of him. John found what was written of him. You are long overdue to find what is written of you. It's important. So, you need the mentality of a star not to end up as a failure. You need it. And to corroborate the issue of next levels, in 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 41, there is one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, and another glory of the star. And one star exceeds another in glory. So it's all in levels. It's all in levels. I don't know, but I know I'm not near there. I'm not near there at all. Because until we come into the fullness of the stature of Christ unto a perfect man, I'm not near the place. No. To command dominion at the level of Christ, I'm not there yet. Yet Jesus said, if you believe me, can I set you a benchmark? The works that I do shall you do also, and greater works than these. So we are not there. It is ignorance that makes a believer to think he has arrived when he has not begun. When he has not begun. It's complete spiritual ignorance. Complete spiritual ignorance. You are redeemed a star. And one star exceeds another in glory. So even as a star, you keep ascending from glory to glory, from glory to glory, from glory to glory. Somebody's changing levels. Yeah. That looks like you. Let me hear you loud as amen. Yeah. The salt of the earth, an asset of worth. Most of medications in the world has a salt base. Salt deficiency will lead to health crisis in the body. So you are an asset of inestimable value. The world needs you. Ye are the light of the world. Ye are the salt of the earth. You give taste to living. You preserve the system from decadence. That's who you are. So you are not a burden to your world. You are a blessing. This should rule your mind. It should help in the way we approach life. I am not a burden. I am a blessing. I'm not a liability. I'm an asset. You arrive at any place, you are looking for what to add, not what to take. You are looking for what to add. You are looking for what to add, not what to take. You are looking for what to contribute, not what to consume. You are driven by value addition mentality. Driven by value addition mentality. You are driven by value addition mentality. I tell our students oftentimes, and I say, I must live to see you scale higher heights than I ever could see in my lifetime. That to me will be a definition of success. I tell people in church, one day I said to God, I said, if you won't bless them, stop blessing me. If you won't bless them, stop blessing me. If you won't bless them, stop blessing me. And God hasn't stopped blessing them. You need to be value addition driven. It's a word. No. This move has come to our coast. We must not mess it up. We must not. I knew a bit of these things in the 70s. I knew it was coming. I put myself on the line to be part of it when it comes. I was praying, I was fasting, I was among the young people saying it must happen. That a time will come, one of those prophecies, that I will stir up jealousy by the happenings in my church. That's what God said. Is it not happening today? It's happening. It's happening. The rise of the church in Nigeria is tormenting the devil. It's rising. And it's just the beginning. It's just the beginning. There shall be a wave of super mega churches across the length and breadth of Nigeria. A time will come when churches like this will be doing 7 services. Poopa, poopa, poopa. Money tonight. Now listen to me. That is what we saw in the 70s. That it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established on top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. We're on this covenant hour of prayer in church by the leading of the Holy Spirit, and by last month or the month of last month, August, 165 nations hooked onto that meeting, including hardcore Islamic nations. 165 nations. Then what remains of the world? What remains of the world? And I mean nations like Bahrain, like Kuwait, like Saudi Arabia. Now you see, something is happening today. And what I'm saying is that may you be awake enough to be part of this happening. Operating the next level's mentality. By redemption, our life is ordained to shine brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. Changing levels, that's the implication. Changing levels, changing levels. In fact, God expects you to experience a change of level annually. These 3 years I came seeking fruit of thee and I found none. Cut it down, welcome on the ground. And he said, let it alone this year also. So it comes annually. To appraise your qualification for next level. It comes in annually. Luke chapter 13 verse 6 to 9. So you are entitled to change of levels annually. If your child is not changing class, are you an excited father? You put a child in school and it's in primary one this year, primary two, one next year, primary one the third year. No, no. How long are you going to be in the same class? I guess that the founders of education philosophy saw that Luke 13, that annually you are to be appraised for the next level. May the appraiser, your appraiser, be favorable this year. You have gone around that mountain long enough. It's time to enforce a change of level. It's time to enforce a change of level. It's time to enforce a change of level. That's God's agenda. Say with me, I'm entitled to an annual change of level. As I meet my Creator's requirement. Your path and my path are ordained to shine brighter and brighter and brighter unto a perfect day. Please see it. I caught that scripture in 1982 and I was set for no setback. No explanation is tenable for being at the same spot. No. See, there was no light. That's why you failed the exam. There was no candle. or no lantern or no telephone light. This is Paul speaking. He said, I became all things to all men that I might by all means. Everybody say, by all means. Change of level should be by all means mentality. By all means. All scriptural, biblical, legitimate means. By all means, not by crook and what. By all biblical means. By all legitimate means. I refuse to be at the same spot. I made a statement earlier on that destiny in the kingdom is not a destination. It's an adventure. You arrive at a point, you say, okay, are you ready for the next? Say, Lord, I'm ready. Okay, come up here. You get there, you say, are you okay? Set for the next? I'm ready, Lord. Come up here. Destiny is an adventure. Now, I heard from God 1982, 17 years before it happened, that at the base of this ministry, there shall be a tent that will seat 50,000 people. Now, that will appear like a benchmark. No. 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 That's a baseline. So first, 50,000 field. Second, field. Third, field. Fourth, field. Now we're already orchestrating for the sixth. It is only a baseline. Whatever it tells you now is a baseline. Let me see how you commit to getting there. And then let me see what it remains in you to move forward. There's nothing in you remaining. You stay on there. But here is an evangelist with inbuilt capacity and potentials to gather 500,000 people. And he's only saying 5,000. And to him, oh yes, it's over. We made it at last. Is 490,000 and 50,000. Remain just 5,000. 4955. 5,000 less, 500,000. What percentage is that? That's a blatant failure. I don't know how much God has given you. but you must keep striving, because he knows what capacity he has built into you. You know, and unto whom much is given, much is required. Many of us are less than 10% of his expectation now. And we just feel, oh yeah, we just, oh, okay, man. Things are fine. You know, everybody here, if your level doesn't change between our next conference, you have not succeeded. Because the whole essence of here is to steer you up, to know that you are entitled to a change of level annually. I can't be repeating the same class forever. No, enough is enough. Enough is enough. You don't wait for things to happen. You either make them happen or they never happen. You work at making them happen. He said, work out your own salvation. In the same way, you must work out your own change of level. Your change of level won't happen. You have to write the required test, the required exams to change class. Even if your father were the headmaster and the principal of the school, you must write the exam to change class. If you are not ready for the exam, you're explaining, I have headache, a backache, you will still write it when your headache is over. That exam you must write. So your change of level places a definite demand on your life. Now listen to me. You can inherit anything, but not status. You can inherit cars, inherit land, inherit houses, but not status. If your father were a professor and is now gone, and he will to you his professorial title, and you apply for a job with him, God have mercy. They will lock you up and imprison you without any prison terms. You just be there. Because you are funny enough to think that you can inherit the worth of your father. You may inherit his wealth, but not his worth. Now listen. You may. So, the worth of your life is as worked out by you. Now, more dangerously, if your father were perhaps a heavyweight wrestling champion and he willed his belt to you, and you are challenged to defend that title, then you now came out. Amen. The professional wrestler will take you up like this and say, where do you want me to land you? On the head? On the sofa? And by the time he throws you down, you are broken to spare parts. You cannot inherit the worth of a man. You cannot. Because I know many of us here came from quite some very fantastic background. Unfortunately, it doesn't make you. Whatever you don't earn never adds value to you. Wealth gotten by vanity shall diminish, but he that gathers by labor shall increase. So get ready. You can't change level on another man's ticket. You cannot change level on another man's ticket. You cannot change level on another man's ticket. You have to pay the price to change your level. Your father can't write exam for you, even though he's the headmaster of the school. No, that will be exam malpractice. They will lock the two of you up. May it not be covenant. If it's covenant, thunder. Okay. Therefore, lift up the hands that hang down and the feeble knees. Hebrews 12, 12 and 13. And make straight paths for your feet, lest that which is lame be turned out of the way, but rather let it be healed. This is crucial. It's said in sciences that every object assumes a state of rest until relevant forces apply to it. And I say relevant with all sense of meaning. Amen. If I want to pick an item from the floor, can I use my teeth for that? That would be some madness. Relevant forces. The bending force, the gripping force, and the lifting force. Otherwise, it will be there forever. We must identify the relevant forces for the change of level that we are thinking of. Amen. For instance, somebody wants a change of level financially. There is no shortcut. You are either a covenant practitioner or you are a covenant victim. There is no prayer of any anointed man that would change anybody's financial status without engaging in covenant practice. Bring ye all the tithe, or you keep living under self-inflicted curses. I heard God speak that to me live, March 22, 1982. My son David, my prosperity plan is not a promise, so it does not answer to prayers. My prosperity plan is not a promise. It has no respect for fasting. My prosperity plan is a covenant. Until your part is played, I am not committed. I had it live from God. I was in a 3-day fast seeking the secret of kingdom prosperity. I caught it so hot, so intoxicated, that I spent, and I can never be poor. And that verdict is in place today. But from that time till my time on that is over, I'm a tither. I was not a pastor then, but I caught the light from heaven. I don't know the meaning of poverty, and I can't know it. I don't, and I can't know it. Now, listen. You can't speak. Now, listen to me. I had the Lord speak to me coming to this place today that tell them that only applied revelation guarantees your change of position. What is it? Only applied revelation. Not revelation. The charismatic celebrate revelation is the Lord. Oh yes, God spoke to me. God said, God told me. God had me. Now, Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. If you will diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord your God and observe to do all his commandments that I command thee this day, that the Lord your God will set you up on high above all nations. That means your level changing. Above one nation today, and then two nations tomorrow, and then 10 next tomorrow, and then 40 another time, and then 50 another time, and then 60 another time. If you will observe to do all that I tell you to, applied revelation is our only guarantee for change of position. It's not revelation. You can die in frustration with revelation. Until you put it to work, it won't deliver no result. It has to be put to work. It has to be put to work. Crying, for instance, can't get you healed. Do you believe that I, the Son of Man, am able to heal you? Then you can be healed. So you are healed on the ticket of faith. Faith in the finished work of Christ. That himself took your sicknesses and bore your diseases. Surely has bore your sicknesses and carried your pains. So you are entitled to a pain-free, sickness-free life. You have to believe that before the healing virtue can flow. That you are crying, oh God, I've been in church for so many years. I've been in church, I'm still having a headache. God, where are you? He said, I've been in heaven. That's where I live. Heaven is my throne, the earth is my footstool. Whether you cry, I'm in heaven. You don't cry, I'm in heaven. You believe, I'm in heaven. You don't believe, I'm in heaven. You backslide, I'm in heaven. You from slide, I'm in heaven. I am that I am. It is you that have a situation in your hand. I don't have no situation, God is saying. I'm the same under all circumstances. It's time to be awake. It's time to be awake. We're a people of equal destiny. Why are some living like destitute? Now, we are a people of equal destiny. He said, the people has predestinated. Romans 8, 29 and 30, he has called. And the people he has called, he has justified. And the people he has justified, he has equally glorified. Amen. Every child of God shares an equal, glorious destiny with others. But how do we get there? As you behold him as in a glass, revelation, and put it to work, we are changed from glory to glory as by the Spirit of God. I believe all of us in this conference are here because God has ordained us to get on the frequency of continuous change of level. Continuous change of level. Continuous change of level. I've been around for some time, maybe 46 years now in the faith. But I've never seen God this close in all my life. This year. I've never seen God this real in all my life. Something happened sometimes in one of our outreaches. One of our men went evangelizing because he got some sense that Matthew 6:33 is key to fulfillment. So he went for outreach, and in 2 hours, he led 14 souls to Christ. And he got home, and the Lord said, go to bed, I want to operate on you. Life. And then he had an implanted steel in his elbow since 2007 in India, because he had a close-range shot by armed robbers. And that arm has never experienced peace. Daily pains. He went and slept, laid in bed, afternoon. And the iron fell off without any opening, without any blood, without any water. The iron fell by side. The iron is on my table right now. This God is real. This God is real. This God is real. This is my advice for us. You don't know enough of God. Maybe you know just very little of God. Be desperate to know God more. Paul said that I may know him. At what time? Abba, with all your experiences, he said that I may know him. It is those who don't know God who claim to know him. Those who truly know God know they don't know any much of God. They are always craving to know him. Moses prayed, show me not thy face that I may know thee, Abba. In chapter 33 of Exodus, what do you want to know, Moses? What do you want to know? You have gone to the mountain and returned. You have seen God write with his handwriting on tablets and give it to you. What do you want to know? He confided in you on the history of creation. What do you want to know? He delivered to your hand the laws that rule the world today. What do you want to know? Is this that I may know you? That's the cheapest way to keep scaling new heights. An undying crave to know more of God. To know more of God. And then just keep going. Again, my prayer is this conference must change everyone's level. Supernaturally. Supernaturally. Hear what God said. He said, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. It hasn't entered the heart of any man. The things that God has prepared for them that love him. So the love of God is a fundamental requirement for change of levels. Every anointed, dedicated, consecrated lover keeps changing levels because of the commitment of God to him. Every genuine love of God is a pace setter, a pathfinder, a trailblazer. You need a heart for God to make remarks in life. You need a heart for God. It's not a Father Christmas. No. It's not a Lajee's God. It's a loving Father, and he has his terms for dealing with his own children. You need a heart for God to make genuine marks on the earth. You need a heart for God. I pray one more time that every one of us in this conference will experience God in a new way. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. It's also clear that every encounter with the world is an encounter with destiny. So people who change levels are world addicted people. They are people that are sold out to the world. What is God saying for now? It was by a word encounter that the man Noah made history. The Lord said, prepare me an ark. A word from the Lord gave him his place in history. And Noah and his family were that's the source of the human race today, by a word from the Lord. The Lord sent a word into Jacob and it turned him to a nation. There are people here today that came in here as persons. You will end up as nations. Because the Bible says, arise and shine because your light is come. And a little one among them shall become a thousand. And a small one, a strong nation. Now, there are going to be an army of men in the body of Christ that will be persons stronger than strong nations. Man. They will be in industry. They will be in science and technology. They will be in invention. They will be in ministry. Men that will be stronger than notable nations. I have a word from the Lord. I will see that happen in my lifetime. That means it's going to happen soon. I will see it manifesting, operating in my lifetime. Because saviors shall come up on my Zion. And they shall judge the mount of Esau. Obadiah 21. And the kingdom shall be the Lord. We're getting there. So that should help us to see that where we are now, at best, is a stepping stone to next levels. We are not there yet, but the grace that brought us where we are today will take us there. We are not there yet, but the grace that brought you to where you are today, that grace, when really engaged, will take you there. Interesting. It's good for us to also know that every child of God is redeemed to be greater than all the Old Testament saints. Have you ever imagined that? Matthew 11:11. Of all born of women, there is none as great as John the Baptist, but he that is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he. Man, that means there are potentials in us greater than Noah had. Amen. Greater than Abraham had. Greater than Isaac. Greater than Jacob. You carry potentials within you greater than Daniel. You carry potentials within you greater than Nehemiah. You carry potentials within you greater than all those great prophets. You carry these potentials in you. But now let me tell you this. Potentials and manifestation are not the same. For instance, John was greater than Elijah, but he was slaughtered. No. Who will slaughter Elijah? Who will slaughter Elijah? He had an unrealized potential. He carried unrealized potentials. So that we have potential is not enough to celebrate. We must take responsibility to realize those potentials in our lives. I'm saying that man greater than Solomon before his fall, greater than Solomon in wisdom, greater than Solomon in wealth. Matthew 12:42, he said, a greater than Solomon is here, talking about himself. And as the Father sent him, so has he sent us. So inside us is domicile greater than Solomon's potentials. Potentials, 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 potentials. Greater than Solomon's potentials. Greater than Solomon's potentials. Greater than Abraham's potentials. Man, I can understand that. He had 318 bodyguards. One man with what population at that time? What was the population of the world at that time? Now, even today, how many of us has 300 bodyguards to do what? That could resist the army of a nation. Abraham was a nation. So when I say there are men like nations coming in this end time, I'm talking scriptures. I'm speaking prophetic scriptures. If you believe you are one of such, let me hear your loudest amen. This is it. And I pray that you will live to be part of it. Every one of us is ordained or redeemed to reign as king, as a king and a priest. We are not ordained slaves. We are not redeemed to be slaves. No. When I say the way some people live, I wonder, do you understand the worth of redemption? How dare you sell yourself so cheap? You get molested, harassed by all kinds of small, small things around you. How? Ordained to reign, not as slaves. Revelation 5:10. As we round up, all I've tried to do this time is to see how much of our destiny we can capture from scriptures so as to change the way we think and change the way we live. Every time I'm told that something is not possible, I get excited. Because it won't be tasking if it's possible. It becomes tasking when it's not possible. Amen. Why? I am in partnership with the God of all possibilities. Now, I had a word, very humbling word, 2nd of May this year. He said, I, the God of wonder double, is visiting you. Huh? I've never heard it. I never read it in a book. Wonder double. And then immediately I got a revelation that within 2 months I will double this church. Sir, he did. This God did. I'm humbled. Humbled. Now, it is naturally impossible. It's technically impossible. But that's when God gets excited. He said, blessed is he that believeth that shall be performed those things we are told from the Lord. This prophetic word, don't think that God is waiting on your ability to make it happen. God is waiting on your confidence in him who said it to make it happen. For what he said with his mouth to David, his hand has also performed it. 1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 15. We built Covenant University by his grace in partnership with him. 7 months. Road network, drainage, house of residence, faculty building, power, water, which we have to supply ourselves. Because I heard him saying, it is I. Okay, if it is you, we front for you. You do it. Somebody's here. Some things have been spoken to you as prophecies, but you have trashed them because you think it is you that will make it happen. Every prophetic word is according to God's capacity, not yours. Not yours. Therefore, I speak up your next levels today. I speak up your next levels today. I'm sure Pastor Paul maybe will have had the story of how we got our first airplane. I was out there in the morning on Saturday like this, preparing to get into a seminar, and the Lord said to me, it's time to get the aircraft. Sir, I didn't know the name of any. The name. Talk less of the cost. I didn't know the name of any. But he walked up to my office and said to me, it's time to get the aircraft. He told me, 1982, that we will run around with the gospel with our own aircraft. Never gave us room to even pray for it. He just walked up. Guess what? 6 months, the plane landed. 6 months. Paid for cash. 6 months. Because God said it, and you are stupid enough to believe it, his hand will perform it. Now, that's the way it works. That's the way it works. Sir, we announce it once in church. How many times? Just that same Saturday morning. Once only. Once. 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 Because he's not asking them to buy it. He's telling us he has bought it. We should go and collect it. Somebody hear what I'm talking about? Yeah. Now we never need to take an offering for aircraft forever in our ministry. We won't need that forever. Please, 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 believe God. Believe God. You are redeemed as a light of the world and the salt of the earth. Believe God. You are ordained for continuous change of position. Believe God. Believe God that apply revelation guarantees your change of position any day, any time, anywhere. Believe God. These are the things that make things happen in our life. Find what he says. Sell yourself out to it. It's impossible to stand out for the truth, to be sold out to the truth and not stand out in life. It's impossible. He said, do all that I tell you to do, and I'll set you up on high above all nations. There are many global citizens rising from this conference today. Nobody may know you on your street now, but as you commit to the demands of scriptures concerning you from time to time, your level will keep changing from level to level until the world reckons with the hand of God on your life. Lift up those two hands, saints, and celebrate God for this hour. Give him thanks and praise. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to pray this prayer over your life. Grace to refuse to remain at the same spot beyond 1 year. I receive it right now. Go ahead and receive it. Grace for annual change of level. I receive it today. Grace for annual change of level. I receive it today. Come and take it. You are long overdue for a change of story. Long overdue for a change of level. Long overdue for a new beginning. Come on, take it now. Take it now in the name of Jesus. Take that grace from heaven. Grace to labor more abundantly in the world. Grace to labor in putting the world to work. Receive it now. Rick tenebro dia yeshagala. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Please, let's give our senior pastor a big hand. Come on now. President Paul. Please come. I'd like you to know I appreciate what you are doing. I don't flatter people. I'm impressed with the spirit of this house. I'm impressed with the grace at work here. And I want to let you know, it's only the beginning. As long as we keep acknowledging the doer, he won't stop doing it. As long as we allow him to keep receiving all the glory, he will never stop. You are on the right path. And it will endure. Amen. This work will grow greater. Amen. The impact will get stronger. Amen. And his name shall be glorified. Amen. Church, be blessed.